Hey, PC World fans, Adam here with Gordon. In our weekly podcast, The Full Nerd, we get a whole range of questions. You can send yours in to thefullnerd@pcworld.com. And one of the topics that I think you can have some unique insight on is sharing the love of PC building with your children. Do you think it's best to buy them a pre-built? Do you think it's best to give them some hand-me-down parts and upgrade your own? Or do you think it's best to kind of walk through the whole process with them and have them pick the parts and build it with them? Well, what have you done in the past, and what do you think's a good way to get your kids into the love of PC building?
Huh, you know, it's a really good question. I have, there's a couple different paths. The one that I think is actually very unique, if you have time and also the money, is you have them spec the part out. The most responsible parent way to do it is you have them spec the parts out, have a budget, come up with the reasons why they want to do this part or that part, explain it to you, and you know, help rationalize why they want to do those things. And then you order the parts, and then you build the parts with them. It's really awesome. And of course, that takes money and time. Not all parents, I will tell you, have money and time.
True.
Option two is the way I did it, which is you take some old leftover parts, you hand them down to your kid, which I think is actually probably the easiest path, because you have the parts, you should put them to use, because we don't want to pollute the planet, so right. You can reuse those PC components like you can with the PC.
Yeah.
You can still get your kid involved with doing upgrades later on. Depending on how young they are, a lot of kids aren't really going to be into sitting there necessarily looking through PC Part Picker, arguing with people on Reddit about what to put in their system and doing it. So it is kind of nice that they just sort of have this system still built themselves, that they understand is something they built, not a pre-built. Now, pre-builts are great. The third option is you do the pre-built, because if you don't have kids, you don't understand this, you just may not have time. Sometimes you gotta go with a pre-built, but you can have your kid be involved with that by helping to pick out the PC they want. They could go, you know, very few options from some of the tier one OEMs, the big boys, big OEMs like, say, Dell or HP.
Okay.
They can go to the smaller folks like CyberPower and IberPower. But if you go to CyberPower and IberPower, you basically can pick every single thing you want in that system. So that's actually kind of a nice way to do it if you really don't have that time.
Okay.
And then I think then you could, you know, as you put older parts in there, and then my son, in fact, recently asked, like, hey, I need a new hard drive because I've got too many videos. I've been recording too many video streams. I need another hard drive to move these things onto. Uh-huh. So that's, and then you're just like, you know what, you need to do it yourself. So, and that's really sort of a good way. He started with the system that I had built for him, and now he's sort of the part where he upgraded the video card, and now he's going to do the hard drive. So it's a good way to get them involved into the best gaming experience out there.
Yeah, well, so talk a little bit more about that, because, you know, if you're going to go option number two and kind of give them the hand-me-down parts, and at some point, like us, if they really get into it, they're going to be like, well, Dad, this 2600K is not enough. I need to upgrade. When do you help them make that choice of, hey, actually, you know what, we should upgrade, or when can you just say, you know what, let's try to do some other things around it, like, you know, maybe get an SSD or something else to kind of improve the system?
That's a tough one, because a lot of gamers who are not going to be into playing the game benchmark are perfectly happy with their 2600Ks, and they have no problems with it. Generally, again, as we mentioned in a previous video, you go with the bigger GPU. So I would measure sort of like, you know what, make them go what real people have to do. They gotta like turn the resolution down, change some of the settings to be lower.
Huh.
Hey, have you installed the latest drivers? Kind of like have them do that thing. So you could sort of teach them some responsibility from doing that.
Okay.
Having a teenager now, I'm not sure that's going to happen, but we'll see. That is an admirable thing to shoot for. So,
okay. And if they do decide to go down the pre-built option, how much can you actually upgrade those later?
All of the OEMs have learned that lesson. This is not Packard Bell. This is not 1993. They basically run industry standard everything. Okay. So for the most part, if you buy from HP or Dell or Lenovo, you can swap your video card, you can swap RAM, SSDs. CPU upgrades, a little tougher, because they don't always support the newest CPUs if you kind of like slide into the next one. You go with the smaller vendors, the more customizable ones with the infinite, you know, options from, you know, again, iPad Power, Cyber Power, the options are infinite there, infinite, it seems like. You are going to have a better chance of doing a CPU upgrade because they're going to use off-the-shelf motherboards with off-the-shelf BIOSes. So Dell and HP, you tend to get BIOSes that they themselves have approved. I will tell you, 7 or 8 years from now, they probably are not going to be thinking, oh, we need to update this BIOS so you can, you know, drop in this new CPU. They're going to be thinking, go buy a new system. So,
so when do you think is a good age to get kids into building a PC?
I would think you could do it right around the fifth grade, even. Fifth grade, they're very curious. I actually did a PC building demonstration, I think, in the fifth grade at my kid's school, and they were really into it. They were really into it. I mean, it was like mini PC enthusiast club there. So people are into it. I think you can actually start younger than you would expect. I think a lot of people like laptops. There's an attractiveness with laptops. My daughter uses a laptop. She likes the form factor, the portability. But you know, desktop is a better way to get people into messing with stuff and upgrading them. So
okay, and you know, a lot of people are worried about giving their kids this powerful tool like a PC. What do you think about parental controls, or do you actively do any of that kind of stuff?
I don't actively do active parental controls because my thought is none of it ever works. Kids, your kid will be 10 times smarter than you, but you know, I do agree with the idea that you don't put the computer in their bedroom. The computer should be. In fact, with our kids, it was a computer out in the dining room.
Oh, wow.
Right?
Interesting.
Now it's in the office with us, but they understand there's really no actual sort of privacy. So, interesting. You know, I mean, don't think about just the PC. You're talking about their phones, there's tablets, there's other ways. Their friends have phones, their phones, friends have tablets. There's really nothing you can do. So I sort of think that is not the way to go. Instead, it's to educate them ahead of time about what they are doing. And then also realize, would that have worked if my parents had told me that? I don't think so. I don't know. We're going to find out. Every generation is different than the last one. So we'll see.
Very, very.
No, you didn't listen to your parents, which is a problem. So I don't know. There's no easy answer. But you have to do what you feel is responsible. But definitely, I think having it in public really helps. And at night, all devices out. We do this thing where it's like, hey, if I don't see your phone in that charger, there's going to be a problem, right?
Interesting.
Okay. Because you think, hey, phone's easy to slip in my pocket. Yeah, no.
Yeah.
Put that out. It's going to be here.
Right. So. Well, I think this is a fascinating topic, and I want to hear what the people out there have done with their kids, or maybe even what they would do if they had kids.
Yeah.
So, like I said, if you have questions, you can send them in to thefullnerd@pcworld.com, or get it in our Discord. If we don't get to it on the show, maybe we'll do it in a special segment like this. So thanks for taking the time to answer our questions, Gordon. I appreciate it. And thank you.